Welcome to Front Row Review. Today we're going to review the movie Sherlock Holmes. I'm Vince Maniacci.
And I'm David Graves.
So, what did you think of Sherlock Holmes?
Well, first, let's take a look at some Normbot footage I took before I went to go see the movie. And it'll kind of give you an idea of my anticipation for the film a little bit. So let's take a look at it.
Well, here we are to go see the new Sherlock Holmes starring Robert Downey Jr. And my anticipation level is kind of low for this movie. I don't know why. It's just that I'm not really that excited to go see it. So hopefully I will be surprised. Hopefully it'll be a great movie. And I'll come out with a totally different attitude. So right now, it's more or less, you know, I'm going to go see it just to go see it. So we'll see what happens when we come out.
I was actually a little more excited than David was about going to see this film. I did want to go see it. As the release date got closer and the more trailers I saw for it, I don't know, I kind of actually got less anticipated for it. It was kind of like, oh, if I see it, I see it. If I don't, oh well.
You know, I can say I never read any Sherlock Holmes books or anything. I've seen a couple of the older movies. But the way he was always portrayed, it was this nice, clean person. And now you're just totally redoing his character. And that was kind of the thing I was afraid of about going to see this. That they were going to mess up Sherlock Holmes.
He wasn't really an action star, you know. And this film is trying to put that in there. Which actually works out great for this film.
The trailer seemed like this was a really big, you know, action blockbuster summer movie. And it really, I mean, it had a lot of good action in it. But when it comes down to it, it really wasn't like a big action film. It was more or less a Sherlock Holmes film. And that's what I loved about this.
I'm glad they came out with this movie. I am, because it really brings back the Sherlock Holmes character, and I think they really needed to do that, because he was a character that's, I mean, you really haven't seen Sherlock Holmes since, what, the 30s?
He deduces all these cases and people just like you would think, you know, the old Sherlock Holmes would do.
40s?
And it was so cool the way he, you know, he does it. I won't spoil it for anyone, you know, who hasn't seen the movie. But it was really kind of, they modernized it a little bit, but they did it in a way that was really awesome.
50s?
And like I was saying, it's not really an action film. It's kind of a mystery action. It's a mystery film mixed in with a little bit of action.
The 80s?
Well, I can tell you right now, it's going to be a franchise. There's no question about this.
Yes, I totally agree. And like I said, you know, to put a little more action in it, a little more adventure, make it a little more kind of Indiana Jones-esque about it. That was a good idea. I mean, they had a good idea by doing that, because otherwise I think if they would have made it like the old Sherlock Holmes films, I don't know if the reaction for it would have been as good as it had.
It's kind of a mixture of the old and the new, so anyone who's actually a fan of the old Sherlock Holmes will probably like this version of it, even though it's a totally different Sherlock that you know. Don't have that put you off and not go see it, because it is absolutely a great movie. As you can see, I wasn't really excited about going to see it, but by the end of the movie, I came out and I said, man, I'm really glad I went to go see that.
Robert Downey Jr. did a great job. Jude Law did a great job too as Watson. I thought he was superb.
Well, everything about this movie clicked. And so, speaking of Watson, what would you give this movie, my dear Watson?
I'm giving it a 4 out of 5, only because it is, when you do go see this film, like David said, it's not an action film all the way through. So if you go there and you expect that, you're going to be disappointed. But the action that is in it is really good. It's just kind of far. It's really far and in between. There's a lot of slow dialogue-ish, lots of dialogue-ish scenes.
Well, I actually liked this movie more than you did, obviously. I'm giving it a 5 out of 5. Bring on the sequel, is what I say.
I would agree with that, and I would hope that they make another one.
All right, so that was our review for the Sherlock Holmes movie, and now we're going to take a short review of the DVD now of Sherlock Holmes. It's out in Blu-ray. Now, both I have it in Blu-ray, and Vince has it in Blu-ray.
Yes, I do.
Even though there isn't a lot on this disc, what they have on here is probably one of the best things I've seen in a long time on any disc. And I wish everybody would take the time and effort to do something like this on any movie.
I would agree. They have a lot of information on this disc. But at the same time, there are a lot of parts of it that are like overlapping. Like once you see it, you'll see it again, and then you'll see it again, and then you'll see it again. But all of it's pretty entertaining.
Well, they do have like a short making of on here. It's probably, 15-20 minutes long? They talk about it, and they have all the actors sitting down, and they kind of talk about the film and everything. And it's okay. I mean, it's good. But the big thing about this is what's called Maximum Movie Mode.
The Maximum Movie Mode.
Now, every single disc that comes out should have this on here. It's amazing.
I actually really enjoyed that. I thought that was a really interesting take on a commentary.
Yeah, and it just kind of shows you how much Guy Ritchie really cared about this film to stand there. And basically what it is, we'll show you here in a second, but he stands there and you're watching the film and the film shrinks down into one corner of the screen, and on another corner of the screen they have like the making of it. And the middle of it is Guy Ritchie, the director, standing there, and he's basically like explaining to you what you're watching here, and this is how he made it. And sometimes the other screen will get large, and you can watch the making of it, where he's talking about it, and then it goes back down, and then it goes back into the movie again. And it's just so cool the way they do it, and it's so informative, and at the same time, really is pretty much as entertaining watching the movie itself.
Yes, I would agree. It really is. It's amazing to watch. It really is. I mean, I was like, wow, can't they do this for... I mean, I would really like to see this done on so many other movies. And they don't do it. Usually they just end up with a... I really can't stand when they just end up doing clips of interviews. So, at least they didn't do anything like that. And this one... They actually, not only do they show Guy Ritchie, but even while you're watching some of the movie, there's pop-up trivia, there's other little making-of things that'll pop up while you're watching the movie as well. And then it'll go back to Guy Ritchie, and it's really nice. It's a really cool way to do things, and a really different way to do it, too.
My parents had never seen this movie, and I was really glad it came with both Blu-ray and regular copy, and I took it over to their house for them to watch it, in which they absolutely loved it, by the way. So yeah, that's awesome, you know. And for a person who's thinking about buying a Blu-ray player, you know, it's always good to go out and buy it, then you have it later on when you get your Blu-ray player.
And I really like that Blu-ray discs are doing that nowadays too. I think that's a really smart thing to do, is to have the Blu-ray and then have a standard DVD as well.
This is absolutely the coolest thing I've seen so far on a disc. And I really hope everybody else goes out and says, wow, that's awesome, I want to do this too. And make it kind of like a standard for a Blu-ray disc. Absolutely great extras on here. This is absolutely a 5 out of 5 Blu-ray disc. Great film, great disc, great extras. You can't really ask for anything else here.
So overall, on this, on the Blu-ray disc, I would have to give, for the extras and everything, and there's so much on this disc, there's a lot to watch, and a lot of information. So overall, I would have to give, for all the extras on the Blu-ray disc of Sherlock Holmes, a 5 out of 5.
Great stuff here, people. go out and get Sherlock Holmes. If you haven't seen it, go out and get it. You'll love it, and you'll be, like I said, you'll have a Blu-ray version and a regular version, so there's no complaining here. It's great stuff.